السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد. كل ما هذا سوى ذاكرون وكل ما هذا سوى ذاكرون وكل ما هذا سوى ذاكرون وكل ما هذا سوى ذاكرون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يستشهد لكل قوم عيد وهذا عيدنا. Every nation has a day that they enjoy, they have a festival. This is our Eid. What do you do on Eid and why do you have Eid? What is it important? Eid or Eid al-Fitr. The example of that is that life. When a person is born and everyone is happy. Everyone is happy. When you see the first moon, the first day of Ramadan, everyone is happy. That mashallah, Ramadan has come. Man, woman, children. Everyone is excited that Ramadan has come.
If you need, you can get a sound.
And then the whole schedule of the month of Ramadan changes for everyone. Sleeping late, very little sleep. كانوا قليلا من الليل يهجعون وبالأسحار من يستغفرون وفي الأموال حق للسائل والمحروم. That this ayat fits in the month of Ramadan. They sleep very little. And they, at night, they cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. And in their wealth, they spend that in the path of Allah. And what is on every person's mind in the month of Ramadan? Every person. Small, adults, children, women. It's Ramadan. I have to read Salat, Taraweeh, Masjid, Quran, Zikr. Every person is engaged. Coming early from the job, working less. Why? يُزَادُ فِيهِ رِزْقِ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Allah increases the risk of a mu'min. Allah increases the ajr of a mu'min. How much is the ajr increased? مَنْ أَدَّى فِيهِ فَرِيدَةً كَمَنْ أَدَّى سَبْعِينَ فَرِيدَةً فِي مَا سِوَى. Allah increases 70 times. The ajr is increased. In every day of Ramadan. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that إِنَّ لِكُلِّ يَوْمٍ in Ramadan, da'watul mustajab lis-sa'im. In every day of Ramadan, Allah accepts one dua of a fasting person. Every day, one dua is accepted. Without any doubt, without any reservation, Allah accepts it. Then, this goes on till the last 10 days come. In which there is Laylatul Qadr. One night a person gets. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that taharru fi ashil awakhir Laylatul Qadr. Search for Laylatul Qadr in the last 10 days. And then he mentioned searching for the odd nights. 21, 23, 25, 27, 29. And if you get that one night, how much Allah wants to give you? إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. Allah didn't say that it's equal to 1,000 months. Allah says it's more better than 1,000 months. 82 years. We're not going to live 82 years. But if you get every year Laylatul Qadr, just think, one night, and Allah gives you the reward and the ajr of 82 years of worship. This is what Allah wants to give. But it still doesn't stop here. Then, the last day of Ramadan comes. How much blessings Allah gives from the 1st to the 29th, that blessings are given on that one day, that one night, which is called Laylatul Jaiza. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, every day in the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees alf atiq in Allah. That 100,000 people are freed from the hellfire. The last day of Ramadan, from the 1st to the 29th, what it was done, that amount is done in that one night. One night. But it still doesn't stop there. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was more forward. And he says, Lissa'imi farhatan, farhatan illa fitrih, farhatan illa liqa'i rabbi. You know, when you tell someone, like a father tells his child, I'm going to make you happy today. A husband tells his wife, I'm going to make you happy today. The boss tells his employee, I'm going to make you happy today. When a person makes that statement, according to his status, the person who listens to it, it affects him. When Allah says that I'm going to make you happy, can you imagine how Allah will make a person happy? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that on the day of judgment, on the day of Eid, in the manner how Allah shows happiness, and he asks the angels, you know, what is the reward of a person who has done so much? And then Allah says that what they have done in the fast of the month of Ramadan, I have forgiven them. And then they have come out on the day of Eid. Whatever they are hoping from me, whatever their expectations are from me, whatever they have in their wish list, like today, every person can present his wish list to Allah. Allah, I want this. Allah, I want this. I want this. I want this. I want this. Allah will fulfill the wish list of every person today. It's just a matter of presenting it. And Allah will fulfill the wish list of every person. For me and you, we may think, oh, but for Allah, nothing is impossible. Everything is possible. And then Allah says that as long as you follow my commandments, you respect my commandments, I will also protect you, safeguard you, and I will also honor you. My respected Muslims, the purpose of Ramadan was to acquire one thing which is called taqwa. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Taqwa is an inner quality, something which comes inside a person. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once told Sahaba, التَّقْوَى هَهُنَا وَأَشَارَ إِلَىٰ صَدْرِكَ. He said, taqwa is in the heart, and then he pointed towards his heart. It's an internal quality which comes inside a person. The recognition of Allah, the love of Allah, the obedience of Allah, the grandeur, the majesty of Allah, understanding that what Allah can do for a person, that connection of a person between him and his master, him and Allah, Every person's connection with Allah. If a person just acquires this one quality of taqwa, all the promises of Quran on that. If you read everywhere in the Quran, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu taqullaha, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu taqullaha, Inna Allaha ma'al ladzina taqaw. Wherever you see this word, taqwa, taqwa, taqwa. It is a spiritual quality which Allah gives to a person in this month of Ramadan. And we wish this is a gift from Allah, which Allah gives on fasting the 29 or 30 days of Ramadan. Now when someone is given something very valuable, very valuable, very precious, what do you need to do? You need to safeguard that. You need to protect that. Taqwa is a priceless and very valuable quality, which today every person has. Every person who fasted in the month of Ramadan, every person who prayed at night, every person has that taqwa. Allah gives him a gift. There is a gift given from Allah to every person. Now it's up to a person to recognize the value of that gift. Therefore, Allah has given me this gift. It's a priceless gift. We realize the value of it or not? Because what will this taqwa do? وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ زَادِ التَّقْوَى وَتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. That there is a journey after that. What happens? The month of Hajj comes in. Ashur Hajj. And tells the person that acquire that taqwa so that you can meet Allah, go to Hajj. People think, you know, I need to have money to go to Hajj. I need to have this. The most essential thing which Quran says, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ زَادِ التَّقْوَى وَتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Then have taqwa is the thing which will take you. Even you won't have it, you'll ask from Allah, Allah will give you and make arrangements for you to go there. That's why those amongst us on whom Hajj is farz. Don't delay. Next year, later on, take this opportunity. Ask from Allah. We don't know next year we'll live or not. Next year we'll see or not. Why Allah has given us this gift? Take the best opportunity and benefit from Allah. The other thing, my respected Muslims, is the day of Eid is a day of showing happiness. How Allah is happy with us. We have to show that happiness. Our family, our friends, our relatives, those amongst us who have parents. Parents is a very big gift, a very great blessing, a very unique gift. Be thankful, be appreciateful. If your parents are living with you, be thankful, be grateful. If they are not, the overseas or wherever they are, give them a call. This is a very unique gift which Allah has given you. You'll only realize the value of your parents once they are no more there. While you have them, you take it for granted. And you say, oh well, you know. But when you don't have them, ask those people who don't have parents. Go to an orphanage. Where someone lived without parents. Ask them. Ask a foster child, how is it to be brought up without parents? And that's why the greatest right after Allah and His Rasul is the right of the parents. Always pray for them. And what is the prayer for them? If you look in the Quran, subhanAllah. Allah says, رَبِّ رَحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي سَبِيرًا. Oh Allah, have mercy on them, how they had mercy on me when I was a child. You know, when we were a child, how our parents had mercy on us, You will only realize that when we become a child ourselves, when we have a child ourselves, when we become a parent, then we realize that, oh, my parents went through this because of this. How much, you know, how much time they would walk with you on their hands. They didn't have the means what we have today. Sometimes children become stubborn, even if you have a stroller or everything, still they say, oh no, pick me up. Even the parents, they did not eat because of you. They did, how much they sacrifice, you only realize when you become a parent. رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي أَنْ أَشْكُرْ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيَّ وَعَلَى وَالِدَيَّ أَنْ أَعْمَلَ صَالِحًا تَرْضَاهُ. Quran teaches us that, oh Allah, this is the greatest gift that you have given us. So those amongst us that who have parents, thankful, grateful, serve to them, respect them, love them. In the same manner for parents towards the children, the Muslim children, especially our youth, they are very talented, very gifted, very smart. The environment what we provide to them in their home, our homes, that's why always encourage, inspire, motivate our children to become a good role model for the humanity. Inspire them, motivate them, encourage them, talk to them, sit with them, communicate with them. They are asset for the humanity. Don't let that one youngster go to waste. Talk to them, inspire, motivate, encourage them. In the same manner, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so merciful and so kind that, you know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَوْ أَشْرَهُ صَالِحًا. When this ayat came down, that whoever does one good deed, Allah will give him the reward of 10. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, رَبِّ زِدْ لِي أُمَّتِي. Allah, make it more for my ummah. It's only 1 for 10, make it a bit more. So this ayat came down. وَمَنْ يُقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا فَيُضَاعِفَهُ لَهُ أَضْعَافًا كَثِيرًا. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah said, I will give you double in trouble. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a bit more. So this ayat came down. مَثَلْ لَّذِينَ فِكْرَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلْ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَ سَبْعَ سَلَابِ لَفِكُلِ سُبْلَ بِنْ يَزْعَبَّةٍ. For 1,700. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, رَبِّ زِدْ أَوْضَعَ a bit more. A bit more. So this ayat came down. إِنَّمَا تُوَفَّ صَابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. We'll give you unlimited. In Ramadan, we fasted 30 days. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ صَامَ رَمَضَانْ ثُمَّ أَتْبَى سِتَّ مِنَ الشَّوَّالِ كَأَنَّهُ صَامَ الدَّهْرَ كُلِّهُ. 30 days and then 6 more. 6 more. Allah will give you the reward of the whole year. Whole year. And if we can, you know, try to make it, try to start this sunnah of Monday and Thursday. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to always fast on Monday and he was always fast on Thursday. So it's a good opportunity to start making this habit. That, okay, every Monday, every Thursday I will fast. And then you do it 2-3 weeks, it becomes a habit. Then whole year you can do it. But make this habit. By fasting 6 days, you will get the reward of the whole year. That's for my respected Muslims. Let's make this Ramadan, this Eid, a means of increasing in good deeds and good actions. And the last and final is that how we were very particular in the month of Ramadan, and how we were very, you know, always rushing towards the masjid. That momentum we had, that momentum.
We need to maintain that momentum. We need to keep that up. And if you make it a habit, the life of a person is like a rubber band. When you spend your time in the ita'at of Allah, Allah will increase your time. All those things what you used to do before, all those things will be still doing it, still doing them. There will be no amount of decrease. But Allah will what? Allah will put blessings in your time. Allah will put His special mercy in your time. That's why once you start doing it, you will see the benefits of that. In the beginning it will be a bit tough, but then when you become accustomed to it, you won't even feel it. How a person used to wake up in Ramadan, the first couple of days is a bit tough. Then after that, it becomes routine, normal. You don't even feel it. You don't feel thirst, you don't feel hungry, you don't feel it. The day passes normally, you don't even feel it. It's exactly the same way that you won't even feel it. What you are doing in Ramadan, you start doing out of Ramadan. What will happen? You have already become the friend of Allah. Allah has already befriended you. Right. Now, to maintain that friendship, to maintain that relationship, you have to keep up with it. Keep up doing what we were doing out of Ramadan, in Ramadan, and out of Ramadan, to maintain that relationship. If you just do it in Ramadan and after that you say, well, next year I'll see about it, you broke that friendship, you broke that relationship, which you had acquired the whole month, going through all that hardship, that relationship which you had acquired with Allah, that friendship which you had acquired with Allah, that attachment which you had with Allah, that attachment with Quran, that attachment with the masjid, that attachment with dua, that attachment with the zikr of Allah, that attachment, we need to maintain that attachment. That's why, even after Ramadan, let's maintain all of these things, what we have been maintaining in Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us tawfiq.